Hello students, today we will discuss transport phenomena, thermal conductivity. I am Dr. Krishnan Kundan, Department of Physics, Shivaji College, Kannur, District Aurangabad. So students, you know, suppose gas is at a particular temperature. No, different layers of gas may have different temperatures. So transport of thermal energy takes place, means heat flows from higher temperature to lower temperature. It flows from higher temperature layer to lower temperature layer. So here transport of thermal energy takes place. So this transport of thermal energy gives rise to concept of thermal conductivity. Now consider a fixed mass of gas as shown in figure. Here a fixed mass of gas is shown here. Now here along origin direction temperature is taken, and see there are three different layers are taken here for study. AB is the layer at temperature theta, EF is layer at temperature theta plus lambda d theta by dz, and CD layer is at temperature theta minus lambda d theta by dz. See students, this layer EF above this AB layer has higher temperature than this CD layer. So we have already seen gas above layer AB is at higher temperature than gas below AB. So number of molecules crossing unit area of layer AB upward or downward per second is NC by 6. The number of molecules per unit volume N. M is mass of each gas molecule. C is average molecular velocity of gas molecule. CV is specific heat at constant volume. So number of molecules crossing unit area of AB downward or upward per second is NC by 6. Now mass of gas crossing unit area of layer AB downward or upwards per second is MNC by 6. So heat energy carried by molecules in crossing unit area of layer AB in downward direction per second. See here, heat energy carried by molecules passing from this EF layer to CD layer crossing this AB layer in downward direction. So it is given by mass into specific heat into temperature. Mass means MNC by 6. A specific heat CV. And temperature theta plus lambda d theta by dz. This is temperature of EF layer. Now, similarly, heat energy carried by molecules in crossing unit area of AB layer in upward direction per second. See here, molecules carrying heat energy crossing from this CD layer to EF layer in upward direction, crossing this AB layer, is given by MNC by 6 into CV into theta minus lambda d theta by dz. Now we will calculate net transfer of heat energy per unit area of layer AB in downward direction per second. So we will take difference of these two, heat energy carried in upward direction and downward direction. So it gives Q is equal to MNC by 6 into CV into theta plus lambda d theta by dz in minus MNC by 6 into CV into theta minus lambda d theta by dz. After simplification, it gives MNC by 6 into CV into 2 lambda d theta by dz is equal to 1/3 MNC into CV lambda d theta by dz. So Q is equal to 1/3. MN means density of gas. So rho C lambda CV into d theta by dz equation first. Now you know Q is equal to K into d theta by dz. K is coefficient of thermal conductivity. Now we will equate this K d theta by dz to right side of that equation first. So we will get K into d theta by dz is equal to 1/3 rho C lambda CV into d theta by dz. So this will get cancelled. So we get K is equal to 1/3 rho C lambda CV, coefficient of thermal conductivity. So we will see relation between coefficient of viscosity eta and coefficient of thermal conductivity K. So we, you know, eta is equal to 1/3 rho c lambda. We have already seen this. So k is equal to 1/3 rho c lambda into cv. So we can write k is equal to eta into cv. This is eta into cv. Corrected value according to Chapman and Scope, k is equal to epsilon eta into cv. K is equal to 1/3 epsilon rho c lambda into cv. Now friends, we will see effect of temperature on thermoconductivity coefficient k. So k is equal to 1/3 rho c lambda into cv. So is equal to 1/3 mn, rho is density, mn into c into cv into lambda. So k is equal to 1/3 mn c cv into lambda means mean free path equation 1 upon under root 2 pi sigma square n. So it gives us k is equal to mc into cv upon 3 root 2 pi sigma square. You know friends, this c, average velocity of molecules, is proportional to under root of T, temperature. So this k is directly proportional to under root of T, temperature. Now we will see effect of pressure on k. K is equal to epsilon eta into cv. Here epsilon, eta, cv are independent of pressure. So k is independent of pressure also. This is reference I used for preparation of this PowerPoint presentation.